How's it going? Let me know. Drop it in the comments. Want to hear how your summer's wrapping up? How's it going with just number of clients, number of sessions, classes? Are you on target? What do you think's holding you back? If not, let's get things moving for you. Today, speaking of, we're going to be talking about pricing. And truthfully, I don't know what it is about physical therapists and yoga teachers sometimes, or healthcare providers. It seems like we hold ourselves back. So just this morning, I was in an online training. It was with Doug Keller. He's a yoga teacher, long, long time yoga teacher. If you ever have a chance to take a training with him, I highly recommend, especially if you love yoga therapy. Hi, Barbara! So good to see you. So I was in a training with him this morning, and he is just a wonderful man. And on a break, there's a large group of teachers and even some healthcare providers. And one of the teachers, they saw each other via Zoom, you know, hey, how's it going? So they're talking to each other on the break. Hey, Julia, so good to see you. We got a couple PTs in the house. All right. and one of the yoga teachers is like, hey, I have your book. She held up her book, right? And there must be 50 people online at least. And the other teacher is like, oh, that's wonderful. And the teacher holding up her book, you know, her book, she's like, tell us about your book. And the immediate reaction of that teacher was from a very humble place, right? Because all of us yoga teachers, we typically are very humble people, which is a very good quality to have. She said, no, this is Doug Keller's training. I'm not gonna talk about my book here on the training. Plus, Doug is a longtime teacher of mine. So the book is really a lot of his work that I've learned from him, and I don't wanna steal, you know, his shadow. And you hear Doug Keller in the background, he's on the break. He's like, tell us about your book. Right? And still, the teacher didn't tell us about her book. She rambled on about how hard it was to ride and this or that, and she never told us about the book. And in fact, the other teacher was like, this book is great for cueing, right? So I see this all the time. Why do we hold ourselves back? Why can't we talk about our accomplishments? So here's homework today. If you have a book, if you have a service, if online, in person, if you have a training, whatever it is, get it in your head. Like if someone were to ask you on point in the moment, what is it that, how does this book, how does this service, how do you working with someone, how will it help someone? Get it succinct, get it ready to go. So when you're on the spot in front of 50, 60 people that want your book and want to hear about your book, you're ready to go, okay? That's the homework, work on that. Number two is pricing. So I'm in a ton of like physical therapy groups and yoga groups and healthcare provider groups and business groups and all the things. And it's crazy to me the questions that people ask. How much should I charge for my Zoom class? Or tiny, tiny nuanced, is that a word? Details about some irrelevant thing in their business that practitioner, we'll just call them, whether they're a yoga teacher, healthcare provider, they're literally spinning on and they're not taking action on, like, should I start as a sole proprietor or an LLC and spending months on this detail? Should I put this disclaimer on my website or not? And they're not doing services, they're not promoting themselves because they're not sure if this disclaimer should say this certain thing or not. Like, so many practitioners hold themselves back. So today we're gonna talk about the pricing specifically. And you hear so much like, well, I just don't want to be too expensive. Or I hear from my students and clients like, I'm too expensive. It doesn't matter your price. I guarantee no matter what you're charging, whether it's $50 a session, I do not recommend, or what I charge, $250, $300 a session, depending on a certain thing, you're going to be out of someone's price range. So first of all, number one, I had a mentor tell me this, or a coach. He was like, you don't want to be in the race to the bottom price, right? By discounting your services or just charging low, low, low prices. And there's numerous reasons behind this, right? Just not only for your own time, energy, trade, but think about what your students, your clients, your patients, how they will perceive you. Because think of the dollar store, right? What do you think of the dollar store? So you're gonna go in and buy a bunch of junk, right? That's probably gonna break. That's what I think of the dollar store. Just pause for a moment. What do you think of the dollar store? If you're still able to type, let us know. Like, is it positive? Okay, yeah, sure, you can get a bunch of stuff. It's like stuff for birthday parties. I mean, do you really go in there to get high quality items? Tell me, I wanna hear. Versus, think about Lululemon when they first came on the scene, right? And their quality is really good. How many of you have a pair of Lululemon pants from like a decade ago that are still going strong, right? You get what you pay for. So it really is this sweet spot. And so Lululemon is another great example, because now people are a little bit more hesitant to pay for the higher prices because of what? Their quality and their service has gone a little downhill. Now they're coming back around. Yeah, I know. Right. There's some great things about the dollar store. You can always find a nice, fun surprise there, but you for sure get what you pay for. And now Lululemon's coming back around with their quality and whatnot. So there really is a sweet spot for you, for the people that you work with, whether it's a yoga class, whether it's a Zoom class, whether it's an online program, one-to-one session, online, in person, all the things, that you can find a sweet spot of how much to charge where you can give a ton of value, you can over deliver. And by over delivering, I'm not necessarily saying giving more stuff, but for me, in my mind, over delivering means getting the person the results that they want easier, faster, more efficiently, all this sort of stuff. So how can you deliver a service or a product that will help your people get the results that they truly desire at a price point that really works? And by the price point, I mean, it's not gonna gouge them, right? But at the same time, is not gonna have it so you're working tirelessly around the clock just to try to make ends meet. When I first started my own business, I was charging $65 and I eventually worked my way up to $90 an hour, and I thought that was like so expensive, and I was just barely making expenses, and I was racing all around. I ended up not over delivering for my people because I was tired, right? I probably could have gotten them faster results by charging a higher price, because I would have had more energy. And they would have been invested more. So they would have done their homework and all the things. So it's really finding that sweet spot. And for me, what I've learned, because you know, my purpose, my dharma in the world is to help people. And I understand that sometimes, right, sometimes the finances are hit hard, right? Whether it's like you're having a health thing, maybe you're starting a business, maybe you just had some setbacks that were unexpected. Right? So sometimes there literally is not cash in the bank. I find a lot of times there is cash in the bank, but people are prioritizing other things like getting their hair done or getting iPhones. And then, you know, they go to pay for other things that are considered to be a luxury, and then they just don't have the money for that. So it's really just knowing how to talk with your people and pointing out like what they're choosing to prioritize, which is a really hard conversation. Completely other topic. But for me personally, I do want to still, I don't want to price myself out where I really can't help a lot of people. So I have prices so I can show up with energy and I'm not having to work round the clock, right? And people have skin in the game, they're invested, it is hard, right? So they're going to work, they're going to put in the time so they can get their results. But also I have options for people that literally don't have cash in the bank, like groups like this, right? I show up weeklies. I gave the same energy in this group. I don't get paid 1 cent to show up, and I plan my trainings, right? I've got my script right here. And I give to this group the same way I would to a paying customer. The difference is, right, when you come up and join one of my programs or a mastermind or an intensive, is it's more structured and ordered and that sort of thing. And, you know, the energy is a bit different. But you still can get a lot of benefits and micro transformations to the point where you can get money in the bank, so then you can invest more, right? So I have free groups, I have free opt-ins, I have a free newsletter. Once a year, like right now, I have a scholarship available. You can apply for it by going to the mastermind page or signing up for a consult. I'll drop the consult link in the comments here. And so I have a scholarship available for someone, you know, depending on what the application pool is like, I will decide a person to win that scholarship. So in that way, I still feel like I'm serving humanity and helping us as human beings, as a race, evolve, no matter the price points I'm charging. So something for you to think about today is, number one, if you're put on the spot, how are you going to describe your services? With confidence, right? And instead of hiding away, because then you're going to miss, she missed that opportunity. I'm sure there's still going to be people that buy her book because the other person talked it up. But what happens if that other person isn't there to talk you up? You got to stand up for yourself. You can't rely on other people. So how are you going to describe you? Or a product or a service? How is it gonna help people? Number two is starting to take a step back and look at, you know, your revenue, your expenses. What are people saying when they're coming to your world? Are your clients getting results? And what is that sweet spot for charging? And then just decide, don't spin on it. Just decide and know that you can always change it. Like, I've changed my prices numerous times, but if you spin in the price dilemma, then you're going to hold yourself back and actually block money from coming in, because people pick up on that energy. So decide. And then if you feel stuck with any of this, I'm here to help. You can sign up for a free consult. We'll go over, like, okay, what's really holding you back? What's your price point? Where do you want to be? All the things, and it's without judgment, right? We do go over, you can look at my consult page. I just put up a video of someone who just went through a consult with me not too long ago, and I'm so grateful for her video. But I do go over some things, your body, your brain, your bank account, and these are personal items, and it might be an obstacle for you, like, I don't want to tell her my stuff because she's going to judge me. I promise, no judgment, no criticism, because I've probably been there, right? I've been that person where my finances were kind of mess. I charged really low prices. In fact, my yoga therapy friend used to charge higher prices than me, and I had a doctorate, right? And I was like, good for him. So he really encouraged me to get my prices up, and now they're much higher than him, and we joke about it. You know, so everyone's got to start somewhere, but you have to take that first step. So if you're ready to do that, you can sign up for the consult call, and you can also use this to apply for the scholarship for the mastermind if interested. And if you join the mastermind right now, you will get the Radiant Being Teacher Training for free. This is a huge add-on. I've taught this training live. It was 1500 at that time, and I've now added to it. I've evolved in the couple of years since I've taught it. I've learned a lot more, and as you just heard, I'm still taking training. So I'm gonna bring in some of Doug Keller's work that I'm learning, or that he reminded me of this weekend. So there's a ton of information. It is what to do in sessions to help get your people results. So if your people aren't getting results, then maybe try this on. There's a ton of actual yoga therapy postures, how to use props. We go over the yoga wall in there, how to work with the whole person, either preventatively or healing from injury. You know that I use yoga in managing my Lynch syndrome for scan anxiety. So I just booked my biopsy, and it's not till September 1st, because they're just booked right now. And anyways, when the practitioner, the doctor that I have to go to, he's out of town for a couple of weeks. So it's just timing. But you know, I'm gonna use my yoga and show up and do my thing and, you know, listen to my body and give it what it needs on a daily basis. And eventually September 1st will come and I'll know one way or the other. So that's all we can do, and that's the practice of yoga. So if you're interested in all that, you can also sign up for the Radiant Being training free. Not well, it's for free with the mastermind, but by itself, it's only $500 right now. I guarantee when I actually launch it officially in the fall, the price will go up towards 1,000, because that's what it was when we taught it live. And it's a ton of content, but it's broken down into easy to digest videos, like 5 minutes, 10 minute videos, and there'll be workbooks in there. There is an in-person component too for those of you who like community or want to see something live in person. So I'm attacking it from all different learning styles, all different kinds of methodologies, and I'm super excited about this because Doug Keller was actually just talking about this morning. The benefit of teaching online and learning online is that, you know, people like him and me, we just love to give content. And it's a lot for 1 weekend. You get home and you can only really use like a certain percentage. I think research says 30% on average people use. But when you have it recorded, you can watch it over and over and over again and pick up the details or work through the workbook again and pick up the details that you might have missed the first time. So lots of ways to take action to really get the, you know, quarter four, the end of quarter three, the end of start of quarter four. So the year, if you haven't hit your yearly goals yet, no worries. You still got a ton of time. The potential and possibility is here for you, and I'm here for you. Okay? So I'm excited to see what happens for the remainder of this summer. Again, next week I'm camping, so I'm going to be putting posts in here, but I will not be doing a live, but I'll be back the week after. If there's certain topics that you'd like me to cover, just let me know. I'm here for you, right? Okay, bye for now.